You're watching the news on Bahrain International. I'm Hamid Shaban. Good evening. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sakhir Palace the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and the winners of the King Hamad Award for Youth Empowerment to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals in its second edition. His Majesty congratulated the winners and praised their efforts in empowering the youth for their pioneering role in the country. The winners expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for always supporting the youth, which opened up the opportunity for them to present creativity and innovation to achieve sustainable development.
Thank you.
After that, verses from the Holy Quran were recited.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون فإذا قرأت القرآن فاستعذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إنه ليس له سلطان على الذين آمنوا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون إنما سلطانه على الذين يتولونه والذين هم به مشركون وَإِذَا بَدَّلْنَا آيَةً مَكَانَ آيَةٍ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يُنَزِّلُ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُفْتَرٌ بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ قُلْ نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ مِنْ رَبِّكَ بِالْحَقِّ لِيُثَبِّتَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَهُدًى وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ صدق الله العظيم
His Majesty the King then delivered the following speech.
ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعى بإلقاء كلمة بهذه المناسبة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أصحاب السمو حضور الكريم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته وبعد يسرنا أن نلتقي بكم جميعا وأن نرحب بضيوفنا الأعزاء الذين نقدر لهم دعمهم واهتمامهم بأعمال الجائزة التي حرصنا على تخصيصها كمساهمة من مملكة البحرين للاحتفاء بجهود الشباب حول العالم ولتقدير عطائهم ولتشجيعهم على التجديد والتطوير في خدمة مجتمعاتهم وصياغة مستقبل أوطانهم من أجل عالم يسوده الأمن والسلام وينعم بالخير والرخاء إن مسألة تمكين الشباب كقوة عمل وبناء هي مسألة ننظر إليها باهتمام بالغ لما لتلك القوة من دور مؤثر في صوغ مستقبل الأمم ونؤكد هنا من منطلق قناعتنا الشخصية وفي ضوء ما أثبتت تجربتنا الوطنية بأن عملية إشراك الشباب في الشأن الوطني هو رهان رابح في كل الأحوال متى ما تم إعدادهم الإعداد السليم بتدريبهم على القيادة المسؤولة وفسح مجال مشاركتهم في عملية صنع واتخاذ القرار لإحداث التطوير الإيجابي الذي نطمح له جميعا وأننا في هذه المناسبة السعيدة نبارك لجميع الفائزين بالجائزة من مؤسسات وأفراد ونفخر بما يقومون به من جهود استثنائية ومؤثرة لتحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة التي تشكل محوراً هاماً على الأجندة الدولية، والتي تلتزم مملكة البحرين بدعمها ومساندتها وتحرص على إدماجها في كافة خططها وبرامجها. وبناءً على النتائج الأولية والطيبة لأعمال الجائزة منذ انطلاقها، فإننا نقدر لكوادر وزارة الشباب والرياضة إدارتهم المتميزة لتحقيق توجهاتها، ونتطلع لمقترحاتهم في إضفاء المزيد من التطوير على مجالاتها عبر مد مظلتها لتشمل أكبر قدر ممكن من مساهمات الشباب. مكررين في الختام شكرنا وتقديرنا للجهود الطيبة التي يبذلها جميع القائمين على أعمال الجائزة، ونخص بالذكر هنا أعضاء لجان التحكيم وفرق العمل الإدارية، مع تمنياتنا للجميع كل توفيق ونجاح. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
صاحب الجلالة
His Highness Sheikh Nasser then delivered the following speech.
الآن سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة ممثل جلالة الملك المفدى للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب كلمة أمام جلالتكم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى، حفظكم الله ورعاكم أصحاب السمو والمعالي والسعادة، الحضور الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يطيب لي يا صاحب الجلالة أن أقف بين يدي جلالتكم لأقدم لكم خالص التهاني والتبريكات بمناسبة النجاح الكبير الذي حققته جائزة جلالتكم لتمكين الشباب لتحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة في نسختها الثانية، والتي تؤكد أن مملكة البحرين سباقة دائمة في تمكين الشباب العالمي وتحفيزهم ليكونوا العنصر الأساسي في تنمية المجتمعات العالمية. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، لقد أكدتم في مشروعكم الإصلاحي الرائد من نوعه على أهمية الارتقاء بالشباب البحريني والعالمي، وأسستم البيئة التنافسية العادلة المفتوحة ليتنافس الشباب العالمي من أجل تقديم المبادرات التي تهتم بالارتقاء بالعالم لتسوده التنمية المستدامة، والاعتماد على الإيجابية في الطرح والتنفيذ وزرع تلك الإيجابية في نفوس الشباب البحريني والعالمي لتكون الدافع لهم في قيادة بلدانهم إلى محطات أفضل. سيدي، كانت دعوتكم يا صاحب الجلالة لتكون البحرين عاصمة الشباب والرياضة قد شكلت لنا دافعاً قوياً لإنجاح النسخة الثانية من جائزتكم العالمية، وبفضل رؤيتكم وتوجيهاتكم السديدة تمكنت الجائزة من جعل البحرين في دائرة الأضواء العالمية من خلال مشاركة 125 دولة عالمية فيها، وتقديم الشباب العالمي 3557 مبادرة شبابية بما يفوق أضعاف المشاركات في العام الماضي، الأمر الذي جعلها أكثر تأثيراً وقوةً واهتماماً من المجتمع الدولي، وجعل أنظار العالم تتجه لمملكة البحرين. سيدي، لقد ركزت جائزة جلالتكم في النسخة الثانية على استنهاض همم الشباب وتحفيزهم لتقديم أفكارهم، كما أنها ركزت أيضاً على معدن الشباب الأصيل وسماتهم العالية وإحساسهم بالمسؤولية، وهو ما يشكل دافعاً لهم للمشاركة الفاعلة في الجائزة التي أكدت مسؤوليات البحرين تجاه المجتمع الدولي. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، إن حرص الفائزين على التواجد أمامكم ومقابلة جلالاتكم تؤكد اهتمامهم الواضح بنهل المعرفة والحكمة والسمات الكريمة لجلالتكم، والتواصل معكم ليكون هذا اللقاء فيصل في حياتهم ونفوسهم ولتكون كلمات جلالتكم لهم دافعاً لمواصلة مشوارهم في العطاء. سيدي، في جائزة جلالتكم نماذج مضيئة عالمية تمكنت من أحداث نقلة واضحة في الوصول إلى تحقيق الأهداف التنمية المستدامة، فهناك مؤسسات تقدم بمبادرات في توفير التقنيات والدعم والتمويل للشباب ولتنفيذ مبادرتهم، بالإضافة إلى تقديم الشباب الفائز لمبادرات عدة في المياه النظيفة والأمن والأمان والزراعة وتطويرها. ختاماً يا سيدي، نجدد العهد لجلالتكم لمواصلة تطوير الجائزة، كما نشيد بجهود الجميع الذين ساهموا في نسخة الثانية، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
His Majesty the King then honored the winners.
يتفضل سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه بتكريم المحكمين والفائزين بجائزة الملك حمد لتمكين الشباب لتحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة. أولاً المحكمين، سعادة الدكتور أحمد ديقان الهنداوي وزير الصناعة والتجارة السابق الرئيس والمدير التنفيذي لمجموعة الهنداوي للتميز بالمملكة الأردنية الهاشمية، سعادة السيد سعيد محمد النظري مدير عام الهيئة الاتحادية للشباب بدولة الإمارات العربية المتحدة، سعادة السيد ستيفانو بانيتانو الممثل المقيم لبرنامج الأمم المتحدة الإلمائي بمملكة البحرين، السيد نعمان الصياد مستشار الاتصال الإقليمي في برنامج الأمم المتحدة الإلمائي في الدول العربية، السيد عبد المنعم محمد مسؤول التفاعل بين العلوم والسياسات الإقليمي، السيدة أميرة الحسن مدير برنامج UN Habitat لدول مجلس التعاون، السيدة هنا حمادة أخصائي شراكة عامة باليونيسيف، السيدة كريستينا ميغو موظفة الاتصال الإقليمي ومسؤول السياسات في برنامج الأمم المتحدة الإنمائي في الدول العربية. ويتفضل جلالته بتكريم الفائزين بجوائز المسابقة. الدكتور رائد محمد بن شمس المدير العام لمعهد الإدارة العامة بيبا مملكة البحرين فئة تمكين الشباب، السيدة إليزابيث بنتخف جمهورية غانا قائمة تمكين الشباب، السيد ديفيد أند ريادا با جمهورية كولومبيا، السيد أوكي إيسي جمهورية نيجيريا فئة الشباب، السيدة سمجهانا كهنال جمهورية النيبال فئة الشباب، السيد براين بوساير جمهورية كينيا فئة الشباب.
His Highness Sheikh Nasser then presented His Majesty the King with a commemorative gift. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa deputized the Deputy Premier His Highness Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa to attend a celebration held by the Embassy of Saudi Arabia marking the Kingdom's National Day. His Highness conveyed the congratulations of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister to the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud, and to the Crown Prince, Deputy Premier and Minister of Defense His Royal Highness Prince Mohammed bin Salman and the Saudi people on the occasion. He also conveyed His Royal Highness's best wishes of more growth and prosperity to Saudi Arabia and its people. He stressed the deep-rooted historical relations between both countries and praised Saudi's remarkable role in serving the Arab and Islamic nations. Saudi Embassy Acting Chargé d'Affaires, Dhafer bin Ibrahim Asiri, expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness for his keenness on further bolstering the bilateral relations. He also expressed appreciation to His Highness Sheikh Ali for attending the celebration, stressing keenness of Saudi Arabia to bolster joint action to serve the common interests of both countries. He wished Bahrain, its leadership and people continuous growth and prosperity. The King Hamad Global Center for Peaceful Coexistence and This Is Bahrain organized a discussion session entitled The History of Christianity in Bahrain, which came on the sidelines of the United Nations General Assembly held in New York City, which aims to show religious freedom in the Kingdom of Bahrain. The session witnessed the participation of the Cabinet Affairs Minister Mohammed bin Ibrahim Al-Mutawa, Minister of Foreign Affairs Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al-Khalifa, Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities President Sheikh Hamay bin Mohammed Al-Khalifa, a delegation from the Shura and Representative Councils, and a number of diplomats and participants in the UN General Assembly. The chairman of the Board of Trustees of the King Hamad Global Center for Peaceful Coexistence, Dr. Sheikh Khalid bin Khalifa Al-Khalifa, called on the attendees to closely observe the Bahraini coexistence experience that includes various doctrines and religions such as Christianity. He also noted the facilitation Bahrain provides for followers of their religion. For her part, the Board of Trustees second deputy chairperson of the King Hamad Center and president of This Is Bahrain highlighted religious freedom in Bahrain and praised the contents of the Bahrain Declaration launched by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al-Khalifa, which contained a number of religious and humanitarian principles.
The beautiful thing about Bahrain is the foundation is there, the history is there, the people are there, the leadership from the top down is there, and this question about finding common ground might seem difficult in lots of places around the world, but in Bahrain it's not difficult. You know, it's a religious country. You know, we have a bunch of people who have an adoration for God, and they can come together around that subject. You have people who are used to living with other neighbors. You know, you just love your neighbor as you love ourselves. That's as you love yourself. That's what we teach. You know, and I think everything is there. And you know, what I said in our meeting here today was, Bahrain has the answer to the question that is vexing the entire world, which is how do we live with people that are different than us? And Bahrain does it by accident. And now finally, Bahrain, you know, Bahrain's been a little too humble. You know, so the country's stepping up and saying, okay, we're going to export this to the world. And it's a beautiful thing to see.
The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Hamad Al Khalifa, met the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Indonesia, Retno Marsudi, at the United Nations headquarters in New York. During the meeting, an agreement was signed on the establishment of a joint commission for cooperation between Bahrain and Indonesia to further enhance cooperation between the two countries. The commission will serve as a mechanism to review all aspects of bilateral relations and exchange views on international issues of common concern. Also at the meeting, an agreement was signed between the two countries on mutual exemption of visa requirements for holders of diplomatic, special and service passports. The minister expressed Bahrain's pride in the friendly relations with Indonesia, noting that the agreements signed reflect the keenness of both countries to develop all aspects of bilateral cooperation and joint coordination. The Minister of Foreign Affairs also met the Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs and Trade of Ireland, Simon Coveney, on the sidelines of the 74th sessions of the United Nations General Assembly, the UNGA 74, in New York. The Minister of Foreign Affairs noted the development of ties between the two countries at all levels, affirming the keenness of the Kingdom to expand joint cooperation with Ireland for the benefit of both countries and people. For his part, the Irish Foreign Minister hailed the growing relations between the two countries, wishing the Kingdom further progress and prosperity. The Minister of Foreign Affairs also met the Minister of Foreign Affairs and Trade of the Marshall Islands, John Silk. During the meeting, they discussed the relations between the two countries and means to develop them to achieve common interests. The Minister of Foreign Affairs met with the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Cyprus, Nikos Christodoulidis. Sheikh Khalid expressed satisfaction with the development of the friendly relations between Bahrain and Cyprus in light of the joint keenness to develop bilateral cooperation in various fields for the interests of both countries and people. For his part, Minister Nikos noted the advanced status Bahrain has reached, stressing that Cyprus attaches great importance to strengthening relations with the Kingdom and wishing it further development. On the sidelines of the UNGA 74, the Minister of Foreign Affairs met with the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Azerbaijan, Elmar Mamedov, in which he hailed the friendly relations linking the two countries. He also noted their keenness to develop bilateral cooperation in various fields, pointing out the importance of communication between the two countries and the continuation of joint coordination between them on various affairs to achieve common interests. For his part, Minister Elmar Mamedov expressed his country's pride in its friendly relations with Bahrain, noting its keenness to promote all aspects of cooperation, wishing the Kingdom further success. The Minister of Foreign Affairs met with the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Norway in Eriksen-Søreide. This came on the sidelines of the 74th session of the UN General Assembly in New York City. During the meeting, the minister noted the friendly relations between Bahrain and Norway, reviewing ways to further develop them to serve the interests of the two countries and their people and enhance coordination on issues of mutual concern. For her part, the Norwegian minister expressed her country's aspirations to develop bilateral relations with Bahrain and improve all aspects of cooperation, wishing the Kingdom further development. Bahrain has announced the establishment of diplomatic relations with San Marino following the conclusion of an agreement between the two countries signed at the United Nations headquarters in New York City in accordance with the provisions of the 1961 Vienna Convention on Diplomatic Relations. The agreement was signed as the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Hamad Al Khalifa, met with the Minister of Foreign Affairs of San Marino, Nicola Renzi. The move reflects the mutual desire of the two countries to develop friendly relations and cooperation in various political, economic and other areas to serve the common interests of the two friendly countries and people. Sheikh Khalid stressed that the agreement on diplomatic relations with San Marino would push bilateral cooperation ties forward at all levels and enhance mutual coordination on issues of common concern. The Minister of Foreign Affairs also met in New York with Nepali Minister of Foreign Affairs, Pradeep Kumar Gawali, on the sidelines of the UNGA 74. Sheikh Khalid expressed Bahrain's keen desire to strengthen its relations with Nepal and reinforce all aspects of cooperation in addition to increasing bilateral coordination at international forums. The Nepali minister stressed his country's keenness to develop its relations with Bahrain in all political, economic and other areas and push the bilateral relations forward to attain broader horizons. The Minister of Foreign Affairs participated in a special conference on the history of Christianity in Bahrain, which was organized by the King Hamad Global Center for Peaceful Coexistence. The conference was held on the sidelines of the 74th session of the UNGA in the presence of Cabinet Affairs Minister Mohammed bin Ibrahim Al-Mutawa and the President of the Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities, Sheikh Hamay bin Mohammed Al-Khalifa. The minister praised the outstanding efforts of the center to promote the values of coexistence and dialogue at the international level. Sheikh Khalid affirmed that Bahrain is a leading model in religious coexistence thanks to the initiatives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa at the regional and international levels. The minister said that Christians are an integral part of the society, highly appreciated and interacting freely like other followers of other religions who have lived for centuries in a civilized society. He added that the Christians are playing their role in the development of Bahrain and everyone is proud of this legacy. The Ministry of Education held a reception for the first batch of students at the Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalid College for Islamic Studies in the presence of the President of the Supreme Council for Health, Lieutenant General Sheikh Dr. Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, Southern Governor Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali Al Khalifa, and the Minister of Education Dr. Majid bin Ali Naimi, as well as a number of officials and invitees. During his speech, the Minister of Education affirmed that establishing the college was an implementation of the Royal Order of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to name the college after the late Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa al-Khalifa in appreciation of his contributions to serving Islam and Muslims. He stated that the college stands out among some similar colleges for its remarkable features as it combines theoretical academic education and field application in its various disciplines. The General Assembly of the International Civil Aviation Organization in its 40th meeting in Montreal honored Bahrain for making a major achievement in passing the inspection of the safety and security of civil aviation in the kingdom. Bahrain achieved impressive results by receiving a percentage of 84, far exceeding the world average of 60. On the occasion, the Minister of Transportation and Telecommunication noted that these positive results came following the international inspection performed last year, expressing thanks to all officials working in civil aviation affairs. He asserted that the kingdom gives considerable attention to the civil aviation sector and to the participation in the ICAO meetings.